everyone, how are you doing all? Hope you all are fit and fine. This is Gayatri. Welcome you all to BioSchool. My previous video, it was on Hans Pehmen's experiment on embryonic induction. You will get the link in the description box. Today's session, it is on organizer and amphibian axis determination. This is very important topic from developmental biology. So guys, please be with me till the end of video. Today we'll discuss in details about organizer and amphibian axis determination. So let's get started. So first we will see the Hans Pehmen and Harald Mangaloid experiment on primary embryonic induction. Hans Pehmen and his student Harald Mangaloid, for the experiment they chose two differently pigmented embryos of Triturus, that is the Triturus tinnitus and the Triturus cristatus. So for this experiment, what he did, he took the dorsal blastopora leaf from the early Triturus tinnitus gastrula and implanted into the region of early Triturus cristatus gastrula that become the ventral epidermis. Okay, so there the dorsal blastopora tissue, it invaginated beneath the vegetal cell, and the pigmented donor tissue then continue to self-differentiate into notochord and the mesodermal structures. So in this secondary embryo, the somites, it contain both the pigmented tissue from the donor and the non-pigmented tissues from the host cell. Here, the dorsal leaf cells were able to interact with the host cell tissue to form the complete neural plate from the host ectoderm that results in the formation of co-joint embryo. Okay. How the dorsal blastopora leaf get this property, and that we can understand from the experiments by Newcomb and Nakamura. So let's see the experiment done by the Newcomb and Nakamura. So they showed that the mesodermal tissue is arise from the marginal cells at the border between the animal and the vegetal poles. Okay, and the newly formed the mesodermal tissues were induced by the vegetal cells that are underlying them. Okay, vegetal cells or the presumptive endoderms, they induce the formation of the mesodermal cells. So what it did, the Newcomb, he removed the presumptive mesodermal cells from the blastula, and that showed that neither the animal cave nor the vegetal cave produced any mesodermal tissue. But when the two caps are recombined, then the animal cap cells, they induce to form the mesodermal structures. Okay, if the animal cap cells are combined, when the animal cap cells are the combined with the vegetal cap cells, then many of the animal cells then that generate the or animal cells are converted into the mesoderm. And the ventral signal, okay, here you see this, the ventral signal, it is a probably a complex set of the signal from activin like TGF beta and fibroblast growth factor is released throughout the vegetal region of the embryo, and this signal induce the marginal cells to become the mesoderm. Okay, these signals, they induce the marginal cells which is present in between the animal cap cells and the vegetal cells to become the mesoderm. Okay, on the dorsal side, okay, here it is, the on the dorsal side a signal is released by the vegetal cells of the Newcomb center. Okay, on the dorsal side a signal, here it is the signal, it is released by the Newcomb center. This dorsal signal induce the formation of Spearman organizer. This signal that induced the formation of Spearman organizer in overlying marginal zone cells. So here the Newcomb center is the endodermal cell, whereas the organizer, it is the mesodermal cells. So how does the organizer form? The organizer is formed by the signal released from the Newcomb center. So the major candidate for the factor that forms the Newcomb center in the dorsalmost of vegetal cell is the beta catenin. So why the Newcomb center, it is formed only in the dorsalmost region of the vegetal cell, not in the ventral region? It is formed in the dorsalmost vegetal cell because of the beta-catenin. Now we will see how does the organizer, it is formed in the dorsal region, okay, and is the mechanism in details. So what will happen, this is the sperm and this one is the ventral region and this is the dorsal region. So just after the fertilization, okay, after the fertilization, the sperm always enter to the ventral side of the egg, then that leads to the cortical rotation. The cortical granules are rotated from the ventral side into the dorsal side, and that leads to the release of Wnt11, Dizabelt, and GBP is the GSK3 binding protein. GBP is the GSK3 binding protein, okay, and GSK is the glycogen synthase kinase. These proteins are released from the microtubule and distributed in the dorsal region, okay. So when there is a cortical granule rotation, then there is the release of the Wnt11, Dizabelt, and GBP, that is the glycogen synthase kinase binding protein, from microtubule, and it is distributed in the dorsal region. Then what will happen, then the Dizabelt and GSK3 binding protein, they bind and block the action of, okay, they bind and block the action of the GSK3. GSK3 is the glycogen synthase kinase 3. Okay. And the role of Wnt11 is to stabilize the reaction and keeping an active source of Dizabelt protein. So as the GSK3, it is inhibited in the dorsal side by GSK3 binding protein, then what will happen? Now the beta catenin is stable in the dorsal side, because the beta catenin, it is inhibited by the GSK3. Now the GSK3 is inhibited by the GBP. So now the in the dorsal side, beta catenin is stable. Okay, and the nuclei of the blastomere in the dorsal region of the embryo, they receive the beta catenin, but in the ventral region, okay, in the ventral region, there is an active form of GSK3 kinase is present. If the active form of the GSK3 kinase is present, then it will degrade the beta catenin, and the beta catenin, it is degraded in the ventral region. So it's a very important point that the dorsal region is rich in the beta catenin protein, okay, okay, but not the ventral region. Okay, so now you know how the beta catenin is active in the dorsal side of the blastomere. Okay, so the beta catenin is stabilized in the dorsal region and it is degraded in the ventral region, because in the ventral region has the active form of the GSK3, which degrade the beta catenin. So what will happen in the next step? So during the cleavage process, the beta catenin enter the nuclei and it will bind to the a transcription factor, that is the TCF3. Okay, here the beta catenin protein, it will bind with the TCF3 proteins, and after the binding with the TCF3 protein, it activates the genes that encoding the protein, such as the cymosis and TUIN gene. Okay, two genes will be activated, that are the cymosis and the TUIN, and the cymosis and the TUIN, they interact in the organizer with the SMARCA2 transcription factor, and together all the transcription factors like cymosis, TUIN, and the SMARCA2 okay, together these three factors, they activate the organizer genes like codein. They'll activate the organizer genes like codein, noggin, and the Buschkoit genes and the dorsal side. So that's why the organizer, it is formed in the dorsal region. But in the ventral region, as the beta catenin is the degraded, so now the TCF3 protein will be activated. As the beta catenin is the degraded in the ventral region, so here the expression of the organizer gene is repressed. At the late blastula stage, what will happen? The BGT and BG1 gene are found in the vegetal hemisphere, and beta-catenin is located in the dorsal region. So beta-catenin together with the BGT and the BG1, they activate the Genopus nodal related genes, that is the XNR, Genopus nodal related gene. And the Genopus nodal related gene, it will create the gradient of JNR protein across the endoderm, and highest of JNR gradient protein it is found in the dorsal region. Okay, so the mesodermal region, in the mesodermal region where with the little or no Genopus related related genes, they have the high level of BMP4 and Genopus 0.8, and that will become the ventral mesoderm. And those have the intermediate concentration of Genopus nodal related genes, that becomes the lateral mesoderm. But in the dorsal region, what happened? There is a very high concentration of Genopus related genes, Guscoid and other dorsal mesodermal gene, and that led to the formation of organizer in the dorsal region. Okay, so you have to remember that beta-catenin and high level of nodal related genes or the Genopus nodal related gene that lead to the formation of organizer in the dorsal region. Okay, and BGT, BG1 with low nodal related gene that forms the ventral mesoderm. Okay, now we'll see what are the function of organizer. Okay, sometimes the question are also asked from the what are the function, sometimes you will get the question from this part also. So the function of organizer is to, they have the ability to self-differentiated into dorsal mesoderm. Okay, they have the ability to self-differentiated into dorsal mesoderm, and the ability to dorsalize the surrounding mesoderm into paraaxial mesoderm, otherwise it will form the ventral mesoderm. And third function is the ability to dorsalize the ectoderm and induce the formation of neural tube. Okay, they have the ability to dorsalize the ectoderm and induce the formation of neural tube, and they also initiate the movement of gastrulation. So let's see the action of organizer. Okay, so here you have to remember the few genes what are present in the organizer region. Okay, so the first one is the BMP4, okay, bone morphogenic protein 4, is a powerful ventralizing factor. Okay, so BMP4, it is found in the ventral region. Here you can see BMP4, where it is found in the ventral region. Organizer protein, what are the organizer proteins? These are the codein, noggin and follistatin. They have the ability to block the action of the BMP4. They block the action of the BMP4, and these genes are expressed in the dorsal region. Okay, so what are the genes that are present in the dorsal region or the organizer genes are the codein, noggin and the follistatin. Okay, that are expressed in the dorsal region, whereas the BMP4, it is expressed in the ventral region. So now we'll see some of the previous year CSIR NET questions. The first question, in case of Genopus levis, okay, which cell make up the Newcomb center and Spemann's organizer? Okay, so the Newcomb center, it is the present in the endodermal cell, and that induce the marginal cells to become the organizer. So the Newcomb center, it is the endodermal, and the Spemann's organizer, it is the mesodermal. Is the major dermal. So let's see which option is correct. It is the option A. Okay, then on the next question, the blastopore region of amphibian embryo that secrete BMP inhibitor and dorsalize the surrounding tissue. Okay, the blastopore region of amphibian embryo which secrete the BMP inhibitor is known as the Newcomb center. This is also the direct question. Another one, Which protein secreted by the amphibian organizer? Okay, which of the protein is synthesized by the amphibian organizer that induce the neural tissue formation by inhibiting the BMP, bone morphogenic protein? So what are the organizer protein? That is the noggin, caudin and the polystatin. So correct option is option B. See, this is the direct question. Okay, then another question. The group of cells of amphibian blastula capable of inducing organizer. So which group of the cell that induce the organizer? That is the leukocenter. Okay, let's see this question. In case of amphibian, the dorsal leaf cells and their derivatives are called the specimen mangloid organizer. Following statements related to organizer were made. Let's see what are the statements. It induced the host ventral tissue to change their pH to form the neural tube and dorsal mesodermal tissue. Yes. It cannot organize the host and donor tissue into the secondary embryo. No, is the wrong option. It does not have the ability to self-differentiate into dorsal mesoderm. It has the ability to self-differentiate into dorsal mesoderm. So this one is also wrong. It has the ability to initiate the movement of gastrulation. Yes, this is the function of the organizer. It has the ability to initiate the movement of gastrulation. Both beta-catenin and caudin are produced by the organizer. No, only the caudin is produced by the organizer. So the option 5 is also wrong. Which of the above statements are correct? The statement 1 and statement 4 is correct. So the correct answer is option A. The another question. The dorsalmost vegetal cells of amphibian embryo. Okay. Dorsalmost vegetal cells of amphibian embryo that is capable of inducing organizer is called at the leukocenter and is marked by the presence of. Okay. So leukocenter in the dorsalmost vegetal cell. What is present? That is the beta-catenin. Okay. Then the next one. The presence of beta-catenin in the nuclei of blastomere in the dorsal portion of amphibian embryo is one of the determinants for laying down dorsal ventral axis. What will be outcome of expressing a dominant negative form? Okay, expression of the dominant negative form of GSK3 in the ventral cell of early embryo. Okay. If in the ventral region, we know that in the dorsal region the GSK3 it is inhibited by the GBP or the disabled, they inhibit the GSK3 in the dorsal side and that lead to the expression of beta-catenin in the dorsal side. But here it says that the expression of dominant negative form of the GSK3, so GSK3 is also inhibited in the ventral side. So what will happen? That will be lead to a secondary axis formation. Okay. Then the last question. Injection of noggin mRNA in cell that will become the future ventral side of frog embryo mimics the effect of organizer graft into the ventral side. This experiment demonstrates that. Okay. So the question said that the injection of noggin mRNA in cells that will become the future ventral side of frog embryo that mimics the effect of organizer graft into the ventral side. Okay. So let's see. The noggin is a transcription factor. Wrong. Noggin induce the ventral fate. No, because it's organizer graft. Noggin is involved in the organizer fate. Yes, it's right. And noggin is required to induce the secondary axis because it will act as an organizer. So it will involved in the organizer fate and it will form the secondary axis. Which one of the following option represent the correct combination of the statements, that is the R and S? This option B is the correct answer. Thank you so much for watching my video till the end, and I'm sure that this video will definitely help you in examination in solving the question related to organizer and amphibian axis determination. If you have any doubt, then please comment down. Thank you. Bye bye. See you in my next video.